January 26th, 2004. You get an email. No links, no attachments. Just one word in the subject line. Error. You open it. The message? A single sentence. I'm just doing my job. Nothing personal. Sorry. You stare. And then, without clicking anything, your screen glitches. Files vanish. Your computer begins to die. In 9.3 seconds, you've lost everything. What just hit you isn't spam. It's the fastest spreading digital plague in history. A ghost virus that destroyed billions and was never caught. This wasn't ransomware. It didn't want money. It didn't want attention. It just wanted in. And it got in. Everywhere. Over 1 million PCs infected in 24 hours. The internet grinds to a halt. US government systems compromised. $38 billion in damage. A digital ghost that refused to die. And a hacker who disappeared. Like smoke. This really happened. Part 1. The rise of MyDoom. MyDoom didn't hack systems. It hacked human instinct. That error email? A psychological masterstroke. People had to check it. Curiosity. Obligation. Panic. And with one click, their PC became a spam cannon, firing infected emails at 500 per hour, faster than any virus before or since. It exploited two primal urges: fear of missing out and the need to fix mistakes. Even today, 98% of people would click that email. That's not just bad security. That's human nature weaponized. But the real shock? MyDoom wasn't profit-driven. Hidden in its code was a digital time bomb, and its target would change tech history forever. But who or what was the real target? And why did it feel more like a declaration of war than a virus? The answer sent shockwaves through Silicon Valley. Part 2. The attack. At exactly 8 a.m. UTC, millions of infected PCs awoke and unleashed the largest DDoS attack ever seen. SEO's servers melted under the traffic. The entire internet slowed by 10%, like a global artery clogged with poison. Why SEO? The company was suing Linux users, claiming they stole its code. Conspiracy theorists say MyDoom was revenge by open source hackers. But the truth is far stranger. Then, on February 3rd, Microsoft.com collapsed. For 72 hours, the world's biggest tech site barely functioned. Yet SEO remained the primary target. Was this corporate warfare? A false flag? Or something darker? But while the world stared at SEO and Microsoft, almost no one noticed what the virus was really doing. And by the time they did, it was already too late. Part 3. The bizarre Andy clues. The FBI traced the virus to a single email address: andy@mydoom.com. But here's the twist. That domain was registered 2 years before MyDoom struck. Was this a long-planned attack? Or did Andy steal an old domain to cover his tracks? In underground forums, rumors swirled of a hacker named Andy OS, a coder who bragged about creating an unstoppable email worm. But when investigators tracked the IP, a dead end. The trail led to a public library in Latvia with no security cameras. Even stranger? The phrase, "nothing personal, sorry," wasn't just in the virus. It was found in 6 different languages buried in the code. Was Andy a team? A government? Or something else? But if Andy wasn't working alone, then who else was in on it? And what were they planning next? Part 4. The global blackout that almost happened. At its peak, MyDoom slowed global internet traffic by 10%. But classified documents reveal an even scarier truth. If the virus had activated just one more backdoor, it could have crashed DNS servers worldwide, plunging the internet into darkness for days. The NSA found kill switch protocols in the MyDoom code, lines that could have disabled emergency services, stock markets, even air traffic control. Whoever made this wasn't just a hacker. They were testing doomsday. In 2019, a cybersecurity firm discovered dormant MyDoom code in Iranian nuclear facility backups. Was it left there as a weapon? Or did the virus spread further than anyone imagined? And if it made it there, where else did it go? Part 5, the ghost variants. Most viruses die when their kill date passes. But MyDoom? It mutated. New variants appeared in 2005, 2009, even 2019, each more stealthy than the last. In 2023, a cybersecurity team traced a massive spam wave to, you guessed it, MyDoom-infected printers. Yes, printers. Forgotten office hardware, still running the ancient Windows 2000 operating system, pumping out infected PDFs like a zombie army. The scariest part? MyDoom's latest variants don't need emails. They spread through Wi-Fi, USB drives, even Bluetooth. If it wanted to come back, we might not see it coming. But here's the thing. What if it already has? What if MyDoom isn't just a relic of 2004, but a blueprint? And something far worse is already out there, silent, smart, and waiting. Part 6. Could it happen again? Today, AI tools are writing code faster than humans ever could. But what happens when AI writes malware too smart to be detected, or too fast to be stopped? Experts warn that the next virus might not just steal data. It could hijack cloud infrastructure, weaponize smart devices, or manipulate financial markets in real time. Imagine your fridge participating in a cyber attack, your baby monitor live streaming your life to the dark web, or the brakes on your Tesla deactivated. And it won't come in through a sketchy email. It'll ride in on a trusted app update, a fake job offer, a poisoned AI chatbot. The next MyDoom won't ask you to click. It'll be your CEO texting you, or your spouse begging for help. And by then, it's already too late. Final thoughts. You think this story is over? That it ended in 2004? Think again. It's still out there, waiting, learning, and somewhere, so is Andy. This was just one virus, but there are others, and some have already infiltrated your life. If this story shook you even a little, imagine how many others don't know it ever happened. Hit like if you made it to the end. Share this with someone who thinks they're safe online. And subscribe for more true digital nightmares, hidden history, and internet mysteries. Because this isn't the only ghost still lurking in the machine.